गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया ग्रांटेड 3 वीक्स प्रोटेक्शन टू रिपब्लिक टीवी एडिटर इन चीफ श्री अर्णब गोस्वामी अगेंस्ट द अरेस्ट एज मल्टीपल एफआईआर्स हैव बीन फाइल्ड अगेंस्ट हिम सिंस ही एयर्ड द पालघर इंसिडेंट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र स्टेट on 21st of this month. So he filed an urgent petition under article 32 of the constitution of India on the night of Thursday late in the night, immediately on 24/4/2020 by 10:30 a.m. it was taken up as the first matter. Of course, the entire trial was done through video inquiry was done through video conferencing, and Justices Chandrachud and M.R. Shah, both of them heard the matter. At the outset, Justice Chandrachud said, why so many lawyers? Of course, Mukul Rohatgi was the main advocate, senior advocate, who defended him. So anyway, 3 weeks stay or 3 weeks protection has been given against the arrest of Arnab Goswami. What transpired? What is the result? Why this thing has come? We have to know definitely. So I am confident that all of you, whether you agree with him, whether you like him or dislike him, Arnab Goswami is a furious, prominent, and in my wife's words, barking anchor. So always he raises his voice, he speaks in a high pitch, and he doesn't allow the other to speak during the so-called debate with Arnab, frankly with Arnab, all these things. He will not allow the others. He always speaks. Of course, he's a lecturer, he also highly qualified, Oxford, MA, all these things are there. Anyway, his school is of different, because nowadays even in Telugu channels also we are seeing people raising their voices and almost about bro beating each other, and they tell so many things over the channel. All these things after the Republic TV came into existence, of course we can say that he is one of the journalists who changed the track. His school is totally different. Okay, let it be like that. Anyway, so there was an incident in Palghat on 16th of this month. What happened is, three sadhus, they were going from Bombay to Surat via Palghat district. It is actually forest route, a prohibited route. Normally nobody goes there except the local people, country route like that. So there were rumors that people like thieves who are taking away the children, abducting the children, or who are thieves. There were rumors like that. Previously some doctor was attacked on that particular day when these three sadhus were going. They were attacked by the so-called Adivasis, and even though the police interfered, even they attacked the police, and as a result of which these sadhus were killed. Of course they are sadhus. So you know that this Republic TV is previously owned by Mr. Chandrasekhar, who is the main stakeholder. Of course now Mr. Arnab Goswami, I think he is the main stakeholder. So Chandrasekhar, everybody knows, is a Kerala, he is a strong BJP supporter. Of course in the words of Arnab Goswami also, we feel that he talks almost his entire speeches or entire the so-called programs are in support of BJP, as other people say. It's only allegation. We don't know whether it's correct or not. Let us not go into the whether he is correct or not, is a different thing. But anyway, while airing this incident on 21st, so what happened is Arnab, a debate with Arnab. Normal will be seeing them, because they will come after 10:30 or 11 p.m. We will be seeing them. Of course, the viewership is more, whether you like him or that's why, whether you like him or dislike him, definitely we will be looking into the channel, because some masala will be there, right? So what happened is, during the publication or during the exhibition or during the discussion or during the airing of the so-called topic of Palghat incident, So he put a question to straight away to Sonia Gandhi, why they are not criticizing the issue. When sadhus are killed, the Congress is silent, and that too Sonia Gandhi is silent because she is a Christian, she is from Italy. And he has put a question to Sonia Gandhi, and he has opined that Sonia Gandhi will write a letter to Rome, to the Vatican City, that these sannyas, sadhus have been attacked and it's a great thing, like that he has commented. Of course, maybe in some other's view, it is an adverse comment, whether it's right or wrong, but it has ignited the trouble. So the Congress people politicalized the issue, and on the next day, so many FIRs were registered against him. Lot many FIRs were filed against him in the states of Maharashtra, coalition government, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Telangana for that matter, and Jammu and Kashmir. So basing on the incident, that means he has created, he gave a hate speech, literally. He gave a speech which incites the communal disharmony, creating difference between different groups of people, people like that, and they have given reports, and they have to be registered as FIRs. So since they are umpteen in number, lot of FIRs have been registered. So now Mr. Arnab Goswami approached the Supreme Court under Article 32 through senior advocate Mukul Rohatgi, right? So incident did not stop. On the night of 23-4-2020, so when Arnab, 22, or maybe on that same night, I believe. Okay, right. On that night, one night, when Mr. Arnab Goswami and his wife were returning from the studio, maybe on the same night, I believe, yes. Were returning to their home in Ganpat Marg, then two Congress workers, they have waylaid them, literally they followed them, they peeped through his Corolla car, and after satisfying that inside, they actually sprinkled the so-called ink on his car, and they wanted to fist him. Of course, his security guards caught him and handed over in the police station. And a case in under sections 341 and 504 IPC were registered against those people. It's a different part. So therefore, keeping in view of the urgency of the matter, since there are likelihood of attacks against him, he has approached the Supreme Court with this plea. So now the Supreme Court has stayed, almost given protection for 3 weeks against all the FIRs, except the FIR relating to Nagpur, and that too, that FIR will be transferred to this Mumbai, where the investigation has to be taken up. So this FIR of Nagpur contained the sections, following sections, 153A, 153B, 295A, 500, 504, 295A, 504, and 505 of the IPC. Now, let us have a quick look what these sections say. As all of you, 153A, it is a section where an act promoting enmity between different groups, on the basis of religion, then place of birth, then race, then caste, residence, language, etc. So article quite opposite to article 15. So the punishment will be 3 years. If anybody tries to create any difference between the races, between the religious groups, right, basing on the ethnicity, basing on the language speaking, or something like that, right. 153B, that is causing imputations against the national integrity. Our preamble of the constitution says that we have to keep up the integrity. If you do any imputation, if you do any act against the integration of the state, they are liable for 3 years, 153B. Then 295A, so outraging the religious feelings of certain religions. So 295A, of course, punishment is 2 years. But please remember, for charging the case, charge sheeting the case under section 295A, definitely the permission from the center is necessary. Unless there is sanction, you cannot file the charge sheet. So 500, I need not tell you 500 defamation. 499 gives you the defamation, then 500 is the penal provision for defamation. Defamation can be taken as a tort, as a civil defamation, or as a criminal. Of course, punishment will be there in this. So the punishment will be also 2 years. Then 504, intentional insult to provoke the breach of peace. Intentional insult to provoke the breach of peace. So please remember, these are the times of COVID-19 pandemic. We are actually in another path, but still this politicalization of the issue, definitely it is against. So intentional insult to provoke the breach of peace. So definitely it is also liable for punishment, I think 3 years. Then 505, this is a statement inciting the public mischief. So this is, I think, punishment for 3 years, once again 3 years. Anyway, all these sections are quite common. Whenever anybody gives some furious speech, we used to book cases, 153A, all these things you might have known. Yeah, right. Now, Mukul Rohatgi, on behalf of Arnab Goswami, he stated that the FIRs were in response to the broadcast made by his client. That means Arnab Goswami. So, linking Congress to the Palghat incident, this is only imputation. So, the Congress people are thinking that the Congress is linked to the Palghat incident. And the second allegation is that all the FIRs were lodged against him to coerce, to harass, and to intimidate him in order to come back or in order to muzzle the media. So, using the muzzle force on the media and see that the investigative journalism is stopped. This is allegation or this is contention, right? So moreover, he says that the FIRs are the allegations of the FIR only based on the surmises and conjectures. Conjectures and surmises. Only uha janitamaina andukanele. They are based on vindictive misreading of only a minuscule part of the broadcast. That means they have not heard the entire broadcast. Have they heard the entire broadcast, the things would have been different, but they are misguided or misread a part of the broadcast, and therefore they filed these cases. And moreover, he stated that now the date has come. He stated that on the night of 23/4/2020, so he and his wife were attacked by two Congress youth, and therefore he is apprehending similar attacks. Therefore, the petitioner never encouraged, and he used to bring out the facts and reality of any incident. His intention, he does not provoke or did not spread any communal hatred or communal disharmony among the content people, and therefore he is requesting to see that he is given protection. Now the Supreme Court also ordered the Commissioner of Police Bombay City give protection to Republic TV and also to the petitioner. So the petitioner must cooperate with the investigation of the case. Yes, so it is a direction. Anyway, now, on behalf of the persons who filed the FIR, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, of course, already I told you 45 minutes in a delusion already, right? Kapil Sibal. Now we'll discuss about Kapil Sibal. He appeared on behalf of the state of Maharashtra. So, he says that the statements uttered by Mr. Arnab Goswami were highly provocative, and he, that means Arnab Goswami, communalized the Palghat incident, because in this case, out of the 101 accused were arrested in this case by Maharashtra police. Out of 101, nobody is a Muslim. And incidentally, the sadhus, that means the deceased persons and the accused belong to the same community. So Arnab Goswami made vicious and tarnishing comments on Sonia Gandhi, who is not at all connected, who is to be commented either government in power of center or the state. They have to be counted in what way the opposition government is concerned with this. That is his intention. So please remember, Arnab Goswami, it is fake freedom of speech. So directly he said, Arnab, you are trying to ignite communal violence by putting Hindus against the minority. You are creating the communal violence by setting many such statements. So the FIRs are different places, they are different places they have given. So all of them do not have a common thing, they are different. And they cannot be clubbed under an omnibus petition, single petition under Article 32. And moreover, he commented, is Arnab a privileged person that no investigations can be carried out against him? Now he has brought Article 361 of the Constitution. So privileged persons, who are they? Number one, the President of India, the Vice President of India, the Governor of a State, Foreign Ambassadors, Commissions, Charge DFIs and also Consulates. So they are the persons, they cannot file any case against him. He is Arnab Swami, a privileged person in that category? No. Therefore, the investigation should be continued. The investigation cannot be stopped because of the fake freedom of speech. Then, on behalf of the state of Rajasthan, Sri A.M. Singhvi, he appeared and he stated that the offences under section 153A and 153B, 153A is promoting enmity between different groups on the basis of caste, religion, race, language, all these things. 153B, imputations against the national integration. They are both non-bailable. And the news debates led by him, they amounted to the promotion of enmity between the groups. So he is creating the communal disharmony. He is promoting the feeling against the rational integration, etc. Therefore, he should not be granted bail and he should be taken to task and the investigation should continue. Of course, after hearing all these things, the Supreme Court gave him protection and also asked him, asked the commissioner to give protection. Of course, the intention of the Supreme Court for giving 3 weeks is to make him appear, apply to the trial court or to the high court for anticipatory bail. Whether he will get it or not is a different issue. Now, this is the issue. Boiling, and it has been commented, he has recently, this Arnab Goswami has resigned from the Editors Guild. He says that editors is not that powerful. Even there are sections among the journalists who oppose him also, thoroughly oppose him. Of course, the Congress government people, they don't go to the channel at least to vent out their expressions. That's why he will call somebody and he will frown upon him. These are the common things we are seeing. Right, now another issue. You might have heard about Kunal Kamra, so stand-up comedian, or we can Telugu call him as Vidushakudu. So on one day, I think January, the month of January, when Mr. Arnab Goswami and Kamal Kamra, both of them were going from Bombay to Lucknow in a flight. In the flight, Kunal Kamra caught him and he wanted to normally make it an issue. He was taking the video and he asked about Rohit Vemula and finally he put the question, Mr. Arnab, whether you are a nationalist, whether you are a casteist, or whether you want to integrate, all these things he has put, for which, of course, luckily, Arnab Goswami did not reply. He was simply hearing with earphones something. He did not reply, respond to him. I think Kamra, I think he did not care him. Anyway, that Kamra was landed in trouble and Indigo, that flight banned him for travel for 6 months or so. Right. So, lastly, I want to tell you, Arnab Goswami filed the petition late on the night of 23rd and he has come for hearing on 24th by 10:30 a.m. So, advocate Deepak Kamal, he says, he wrote a letter, in fact, he wrote a letter to the Secretary General of the Supreme Court against working of the top courts registry. He says there is a discrimination in terms of listing on the basis of urgency of cases. If the advocate is powerful or if influential, if the person is influential, normally they come to the first, leaving aside all the pending cases. So he filed the case on that Thursday night and the matter came up on Friday as first hearing. This law. Therefore, definitely, he says the immediate listing of Arnab petition, which was filed so and so at 10:30 a.m. without pointing out any defense, without any urgency letter, etc., by ignoring the earlier list of pending matters. So he says that it is unequal opportunity in the listing of the so-called petitions. Of course, judiciary, of course, we are seeing also anyway. We cannot comment on the judiciary anyway. If it is known to the judges, better look into the matter, because in that rape case also, even though that woman sent the letter, nobody looked into it. When again she was attacked in that Kannav case, Unnav case, so things will happen anyway. So this is the long story of Arnab Goswami. Better you hear the video once, twice, so that you will be able to know all the legal aspects and constitutional aspects also. Friends, if at all you want me to make any more videos on legal topics, you can put suggestions, and please subscribe to my channel, Legal Matters by Sankara Sai Babu. Thank you. Thank you very much.